So welcome to Yoga with Smiles. We do yoga together on Friday evenings, and today on Tuesday evening we are going to give you smile tips. Ready for that? And as usual, I would like to start with a story. Okay, so this is something that happened just last week in our building. We ladies had come back from a walk, and we were about to enter our lift. And the minute we entered the lift, we saw one tiny lizard on the floor. And you should have seen the reaction. The ladies are screaming and shouting, "Oh my God, lift, lift!" And we went inside and we came outside, and you know, we did not know what to do. And you know, one person is doing like that, and one person is closing their eyes, and one person is screaming, and all because there was one lizard in the lift. And obviously we do not want to be locked inside a small pokey lift next to one lizard. So what did we do? We called the security man, we called the watchman. And what did the watchman do? Very coolly, he opened the lift, went inside, he had one paper with him. He caught that lizard with the paper, took the lizard out of the lift, and walked out as if nothing happened. So my question to you is, the incident is the same. One lizard on the floor. But that one lizard had absolutely no emotions in the watchman. For him, it was just another day. Just going up, picking one lizard and putting it out of the, he threw it in the garden. But for the ladies, it was such a big deal. So tell me, who is responsible for the emotions, the different kind of fear, horror, shock, all those kind of emotions? Who's responsible? Or indifference? Who is responsible for the emotions that happen in your life? Tell me.
We ourselves.
You yourselves. We ourselves, isn't it? What happened is different, and the emotions that it generated in us is different. Actually, there's no connection. What happened is what happened. And one incident can give rise to, the same incident can give rise to different emotions among different people. Okay? So today, I'm going to tell you something about emotions, managing emotions. Okay? Most of the time, how we go through in life is that we are just a victim to our emotions. We generally have no control over our emotions. So we are going through life and we get up. Think about yourself, how you get up in the morning. You get up very balanced and suddenly you go to the bathroom and the paste is not there. I say, "Shit, what is this? The toothpaste is over. And then you get upset, and then you go, you see your family, and then you're saying good morning. And then again, sometimes you're on a high emotion, sometimes you're in a low emotion, sometimes you're happy, sometimes you're sad, sometimes you're upset, sometimes you're hopeful. So you go through the whole day with a mixture of positive kind of emotions and negative kind of emotions. And most of the time, we are not even aware that we are generating these kinds of emotions within us. So the first step about managing emotions is to be aware of your emotions. So emotional awareness is the first step. Be aware of what are the different emotions that are ruling your life at this moment. So as of now, if I were to tell you, draw one face. You know, you have your phone number, I mean, your phone, you have all these emoticons, isn't it? 101 emoticons you have, correct? And if I were to tell you, draw what represents you. If I ask you, how are you? How are you feeling right now? How are you feeling? So somebody, you meet someone in the evening and they say, how are you? And what is the answer you give almost always?
I'm good, fine.
Good, good.
I'm fine. I'm good. You know? But ask yourself, heart of hearts, are you really feeling fine? You probably just had a fight with somebody, or you just got some bad news, or you just felt upset about something, or maybe you're sad. There are 101 emotions that are actually going down inside. But somebody asks us, how are you? And we say, we are fine. And we hide all the emotions that are going inside. And these unexpressed emotions, they are not hiding. They will all go and store in some place or the other in your body. And one fine day, it will come out like one disease. So emotions is something which we are taken for granted. And today's session is about emotional awareness and emotional management. Okay? So there's nothing wrong in expressing your emotions. We are human. It is natural. Sometimes we go through positive emotions. Sometimes we go through negative feeling emotions. That is natural. So the first step, just be aware of what kind of incidents trigger what kind of emotions in you. If you allow yourself to be at the mercy of emotions, then all the time you're only reacting to life. But you understand that the same situation can trigger positive feeling emotions and negative feeling emotions. Is it possible? Is it possible? Yeah? Simple thing like COVID, or not simple, maybe complicated thing like COVID. Initially, it triggered a lot of negative emotions. But now at hindsight, when we look at it, we say, oh, it's a good thing that happened. The world needed this cleansing. You know, I needed to spend time with myself. I needed to slow down. There are so many good things that I can see of what has happened around me. Of course, people have lost. There are a lot of negative things also, but I can see a lot of positive things also that would have happened. It has taught us we can learn to live with minimalistic things. We need not go and, you know, keep on spending on unnecessary things. We have collected so many things in our life. It's time to give away. It's time to declutter your home. It's time to declutter your life. All this would not have been possible if COVID was not there. So every single situation has got a positive feeling emotion or a negative feeling emotion. Okay? So can you be aware of that? That is the first step. Be aware of your emotions. The second step is how are you going to manage your emotions? Emotional management. Okay, today I'm only talking about your own emotions. I'm not talking about the emotions of other people. That will be some other topic. But today I'm just talking about your own emotions. How do you manage your emotions? So, think about it, okay? If we go through our life, and we go through the different, situations that we have faced in our life. Okay? Think of one incident of a childhood. One strong incident, the first incident that comes to your mind. Some incident about your childhood. Think. Okay? Close your eyes and just think. Before that, think, just go back to the time you were born. How were you born? You were born whole, perfect, complete, isn't it? When you wanted to smile, you smiled. When you wanted to cry, you cried. And even when you cried, people around you were smiling. Correct? I call that whole, perfect, complete self, which is still there inside you, I call that your smile maker self. Okay? You made smiles when you were born. whether whatever it is, you are making you, and you are born in a certain family, so your family gave you certain values, and you know, whatever the your school that you went to, the community that you grew up with, that is your foundation. And then when you were small, I told you, think of one incident, the first incident that comes in your mind, where it triggered a very strong emotion in you. For example, suppose you had to practice for a school event and you were practicing this song, you were singing, your mother was teaching you and your friends were motivating you, and you practiced and practiced. But then when you went actually and stood in front of the stage and 500 people staring at your face, what happened to your song? You forgot about it. And the whole school is laughing at you. Now, this is an incident that happened when you were probably 5 or 6 years old. But that 5 or 6 year old person has made a belief. Whenever there's a strong incident in your life, it will always be accompanied by strong emotions. And whenever you have had strong emotions, it can be positive or negative, but whenever you have had strong emotions, you'll remember it because it's a negative emotion. You will also make a strong belief. So you probably made the belief that, oh, you know, I do not know how to talk in front of groups of people. I have a lot of college friends now in this group, like Debbie and Rose and everyone. We all used to sit on the same bench together. So think of an incident in college. Okay? You've got new freedom. You went and you met a lot of boys and girls first time. And there was one good looking boy. And you just felt that you should just, you know, somebody said, I dare you. And you went and he said, chalo, let me go and I just go and tell that boy, you know, you're so good looking. And guess what? That boy insults you so badly in front of all his friends, in front of your friends. And then you are so shocked. You're emotionally, you had some experience with some boy, and you feel so emotionally traumatized. And every time there's a strong emotion, whether you like it or not, you are making another belief. So you make a belief that please do not express yourself fully. Because if you express yourself fully, you're going to make a fool of yourself. So today you're married, you've got family, you've got children. But somewhere, something inside you says, don't express yourself fully. Think of the time that you started to work. You're so happy. You got your first job. You got your first pay. And your friend came back and told your good friend, you know, at work, whoever you're very close to, said, urgently, I need some money. And then you were very generous and you gave the money. And the friend that you trusted the most, that new office friend that you made after 1 month, one day the money also disappeared and the friend also disappeared. And again, one strong emotion. How can somebody be like this? Don't trust. Money and friendship doesn't match. And again, you make one belief. Be very, very careful when it comes to your money. So you keep making beliefs about money, you keep making beliefs about people, you keep making beliefs about situations, you keep making beliefs about yourself, you keep making beliefs about your abilities. And you realize that all these beliefs start because you have gone through something very strong in your emotions. I'm just showing you the connection between your emotions and your actual life. If you allow your emotions to keep dominating you, you will just end up making all kinds of labels about people, about yourself, about persons, about situations. And once you make a belief, every single thing and every single incident, every single behavior will add to the belief. If you have decided that somebody is bad, your mother-in-law is bad, or your children are like that, or whatever it may be, anything, whatever belief you have about them, it will just add to it. Every single incident will say, see, I told you so. Again, she's making me cry. Again, I'm feeling so bad. Okay? And this belief actually becomes your attitude. Then you may attend 101 smiling tips sessions like mine. You may listen to 101 stories. You may listen to read 101 self-help books. Because you want to change your behavior and you want to be happy and you want to be peaceful and you want to be relaxed. But it's absolutely no use. You cannot change external behavior until you change the internal attitude. And you cannot change your internal attitude until you change the beliefs. See, till the beliefs, till everything depends on external circumstances, which is not in your hand. COVID happens, it's not in your hand. Somebody behaves bad, it's not in your hand. Somebody talks nonsense about you, it's not in your hand. Your situation is like this today, not in your hand. So what is in your hand? What is in your control? What is in your control is the way you emotionally react to that situation. If you just allow your emotions to rule, then you'll be reacting. If you have a choice, but for every single thing you have a choice. You have a choice to grumble about it and get angry, irritated, upset, frustrated, sad about it. Or you have a choice to use that as a learning experience. Use that as a step towards making yourself a better person. Is it possible that somebody can talk bad to me and I can still give love to that person? Because I rather remember the lovely memories I had with that person. Is it possible? See, every incident that happens in your life is a chance for you to grow. So it starts at the emotion level. Okay, so see whether you can manage your emotions, and this is where my smile maker theory comes. I keep talking about finding smiles and making smiles, whatever your situation. So smile is an expression of positivity. Okay, so what you can do is that for the same situation, the initial reaction will be one of negativity. Accept that. But then you have a choice of seeing the positiveness in that same situation. And you can smile. You know, that lady, she kept on criticizing me all the time. I really feel sorry for her. She has no better work than to just find faults all the time. What to do? That is her situation. But I am blessed because I have 101 other good things that are happening in my life. And I can focus my energy on the 99 good things that are happening in my life instead of focusing my energy on that one person lady who's always criticizing me. Isn't this a better way to manage your emotions? Yeah? Yes or no? Till now you never even knew that you had a choice. Now I'm telling you that yes, you have a choice. For every single situation that happens in your life, every single person who you attract in your life, you have a choice on how you can respond with your emotions. And that is what is, I'd rather respond with finding the positiveness in that, and I'd rather respond by managing to find a smile and make somebody else smile around me. Okay? So that is what the smile maker theory is. Smile maker theory is that whatever the situation, we all have that ability to find smiles and make smiles in spite of a situation. We have that ability and we have to have the willingness also. Ability is there in all of us, but most of us are not willing. We enjoy sitting in that sad emotional state because we can get to grumble about them. We get to show that we are right. We get to show that, you know, the world is unfair. We get nice of some attention. Sometimes you want attention. So every single thing has got some benefit for us. Even grumbling has some benefit because we want to show everybody can see, look at me, such a good person I am. So don't go into the details. All I want to make you aware is that you have a choice on to whether you want to hold on to something or whether you want to move on to something. You have a choice whether you want to react or whether you want to respond. You have a choice whether you want to grumble or whether you want to smile. Every single thing is a choice. So if you just stick to the basic mantra of my smile maker principle, find smiles and make smiles, whatever your situation, then that is a fundamental mantra which will help you to manage your emotions. Okay? Of course, I get emotional. I will pick up the phone and I will talk to people whom I trust, who will not judge me, who will not talk about me. And I will tell them, look here, I am so pissed off. I am so angry. You know? And then once I get it out of my system, then I choose, okay, come on, now it's time for me to move on. So there are different ways in which we can react to our emotions. There is no right way, there is no wrong way. But I think what is important is emotional awareness of your own feelings, understanding and emotional management. Perceiving, understanding and expressing your own feelings. Perceiving, understanding and expressing, managing your feelings and emotions. Okay? Now I have 13 minutes more. Quickly, there is one chakra which is associated with your emotions, and that is the second chakra. I've been doing this energy center series, and we already finished the base chakra, where we said it's about balance. It's about, you know, balancing the positive and negative attitude. And the second chakra is about your emotions. Okay? So if this second chakra of yours is not balanced, what happens is either you'll be highly emotional or you'll be dead. No emotional at all. You'll be indifferent. Okay? And this chakra is associated with the element of water. So if this chakra is imbalanced, what happens? It's your water, like, you know, your urinary tract issues that you have, or your sex issues that you have, all those, whatever's around this area. This energy center lies about four fingers below your navel. Okay? And so you have to work on managing the emotions of this energy center. And how you do that, the color associated with this energy center is orange. And the element associated is water. So drink lots of water, keep yourself hydrated, and surround yourself with orange. You know, eat a lot of orange foods like oranges, mangoes, papayas, anything orange. Okay? There is a beach mantra for this. When you're doing your gratitude meditation, so the first step is when we want abundance and materialism in our life. That is the first chakra. Once we have that basic security, once we have that basic financial food, clothing, shelter, financial security, the next is that we have certain desires and wishes. When these desires and wishes are not fulfilled, that's the time we have emotional issues. So when you are doing a meditation for the second orange chakra, I want you to close your eyes and be thankful for in advance for all the wishes and desires of your life. Do you get that? So you close your eyes. Imagine there's an orange chakra moving front and back, 4 inches below your navel. And close your eyes and just 3 times you'll repeat this. Thank you for balancing and fulfilling my desires and wishes. Thank you for balancing and fulfilling my desires and my wishes. Thank you for balancing and fulfilling my desires and my wishes. Why do I say balancing and fulfilling? See, sometimes the universe fulfills your desires, but sometimes the universe balances your desires. In the sense, it may not give you what you want at that time, but it has a bigger thing in store for you, and it wants to give you something more better. Okay? Like, for example, I remember when I went abroad, I was just praying that, please, can I always go? We always travel separately for some reason or the other. And I said, at least when I'm starting a new life, I want to travel together with my husband. And as luck would have it, the office made some mistake. And again, I was traveling in a different flight. And we were not traveling together. And I said, why is this universe not allowing us to travel together? I'm starting a new life, and again, we are going to live separately all the time. You won't believe, this airline that I traveled on, when I was coming back, they told me that they're having some issues. And they said, you know, can you just change your flight? We will give you a free return ticket instead. So imagine the universe. I sacrificed traveling together with my husband, but in return, I got a free ticket from the airline. So the universe knows that it has something better to give you. Understand? So anything that happens, if it is not fulfilling a desire, say it is balancing my desires. That is one of the ways to manage your emotions. The next thing is, there is a Beej mantra, a secret mantra for activating this second energy center, and it is called VAM. Okay, V-A-M. I told you every center has got a different energy. So again, we will say this 9 times. Okay, close your eyes. Again, imagine that this orange chakra is going front and back, and you say VAM. Concentrate on that, your below your navel, okay? VAM. 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 There are also some yoga poses which concentrate on expanding your base. So, you know, when you're sitting right now here, there's something called the butterfly pose. So, holding your legs and flapping your thighs, okay? You have to do exercises which twist this part of your body, okay? So it's like the butterfly pose. Then there is one Trikonasana. I don't know whether you know that. Paschimottasana. So there are many asanas which concentrate on this part. So what you need to do is stretch behind as much as you can. Hold on to 9 counts. I prefer these holding ones. 6, 7, 8, 9. Again, touch your floor. Okay, this activates your orange chakra. Count 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's another yoga asana which activates this part, is Trikonasana. Keep your legs, spread them apart, put your hands apart, and twist yourself, okay? So, touch your right finger to your left toe and look up to your left hand. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Got it? Similar thing, you do it on the left side. So, you can see the twist in this area. Okay? Your left hand on your right toe. Keep looking up. Right hand, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so look it up. You will see how important it is to work on your different energy centers. I've covered most of the energy centers, and I hope this has been useful to you. Okay, week after week, we will show you the connection between smile tips and the soft skill tips that I give you. and the energy centers, which with yoga you can activate.